On planet Earth, fresh water is the source of life on land. How we manage our fresh waters, including the rain, dictates the environment that future generations will inherit. To easily understand this, consider the bank of fresh water in the Earth as a bank account. If we're always drawing from our bank account and never making any deposits, we all know how that goes. Eventually, something comes up and we need a little extra, and it's not there. Then we get into a cycle of increasingly severe and crippling debt. It becomes very difficult to get out of this feedback loop of scarcity. In contrast, if we're always depositing more into our bank account than we're drawing from it, we also know how that goes. When something comes up and we need a little extra, we have it on hand in our savings from a year when we had more than we needed. The same is true for the bank of fresh water in the earth. But instead of money, it's the productivity, abundance, and health of life on land, the ecosystems that regulate our climate, and the healthy underground aquifers that provide surplus in times of need. Let's take a closer look at this with an agricultural example. Two farmers with different water and land management practices. In the conventional setting, the farmer clears the vegetation each year to seed a crop. The rain meets a hardened, bare soil, and most of it is runoff, with little infiltration, also creating a flood downstream. The landscape goes dry relatively quickly, and the farmer irrigates from the aquifer to keep things growing. This works at first, and the crop is harvested, and the yield is high. The cycle repeats, with the rain mostly as runoff, taking with it nutrient and sediment. The crops run short on water, so the farmer irrigates from the underground aquifer. This is continually drawing from the water bank account without making any deposits. As the quality of the soil degrades year after year, the farmer needs to add more and more chemicals and fertilizers to achieve the same yields. Profits and fertility start to reduce. The water bank gets lower and lower as the farmer draws upon the deposits made over an eternity. Eventually, the bank account has run out. This farmer and their landscape has gone broke. Now let's look at that same landscape with a farmer that has a different way of managing water and cultivating land. Decentralized water retention is created throughout the landscape. When the rains come, they are received instead of rejected. The infiltration throughout the landscape starts to make deposits into Earth's water bank. A huge diversity of species are cultivated instead of only a small handful. Many of these crops still produce, even if some fail due to seasonal variation. The harvest is more complicated, but the overall yield has also increased, and the farmer's production is more resilient. This farmer focuses on increasing recharge and decreasing discharge, that each year they're returning more water to the earth than they're taking out. Because of this, with each passing year, the land is increasingly fertile and productive. The crops stay hydrated for longer into the dry season, and there's less need for and dependence upon irrigation. More water becomes available, both to this farmer and their neighbors. As the vegetation gets more established, the rain infiltrates more easily and deeply, Flooding downstream is reduced, and the flow of the waterways in the dry time is increased. As the perennial systems start to produce, the land becomes even more productive, even as inputs and maintenance are reduced. The ecosystem flywheel of nature starts to take over. Each year, the profits of the farmer and the productivity of their landscape increases. This kind of farmer is a hero, through their actions, making more life, abundance, and future prosperity on Earth.